Welcome back to the Play It Again radio show on TSN 690. Sean Campbell, Keith Pogue, Gerard Gantus, as we are every Saturday at 9 and Sundays at 6.
They like us so much they want to play it again. Play it again.
Look at you.
Play it again.
That'll be our promo. All right, so if it's Saturday, good day. If it's Sunday, good day.
Right.
But we are talking with John Silver from Cooper Academy and Athletic Republic. We were just talking a little bit about Athletic Republic before, and we were talking about how you do have at Athletic Republic, you have relationships with organizations, including Cooper and the Lac St. Louis Lions.
Yeah.
The Cooper is because you coach there, right?
Absolutely, yeah. We have... You know, we've built a relationship with a bunch of people. My partner, who's in Laval, he's
your brother, right? Your mom wants you to say his name. Say it.
Yeah, Jared, who's my partner. He runs the one in Laval. He's also partnered up with school George Vanier. They play in the LHPS, which is the traveling prep school region across Quebec. Also, we were fortunate in Pierrefonds to train all the Lions players this summer. You know, we've built a great relationship with them.
Well, you're both former Lions.
Yourself are both,
and your brother.
Absolutely, yeah.
Right?
He was a first liner. I was a third liner. But
okay.
Third's good, though.
Third's good.
I the bronze medal at the Olympics.
I remember you in study hall. I know why you were a third liner.
Exactly. That's we won't go there. But
you know what? You were able to turn your Lions career into heading over to prep school, then prep school into college. And I know that's what a lot of kids at Cooper want to do. And I know that's something that you do regularly with these kids because they're multi-sport athletes. And you mentioned when you went to prep school, you didn't just play hockey, you know,
you
little golf, but these kids at Cooper, when they go to Cooper, they have to play other sports. They have to play a little football. Was it three sports minimum?
Two sports minimum with an option for a third. Our athletic director, George Martin, does a great job of that. Most of our hockey players, that's why our season ends in, February so that they can play lacrosse. We have some kids playing soccer right now. Hockey is... for these kids, the guideline to get to the prep school, but they have to be all-around athletes. That's a big part of
academic athletes.
Right.
Well, that's one of the things for parents out there that, want to know about that prep school route, because we talk about this all the time on this show, is what is the right route to get your kid, to the next level?
Yeah.
Or is what is the right route to get your kid a free education? Or
right.
what is the right route, whatever it is. And I know each kid has their own path, but you know the prep school route very well because of what your kids go through and what you went through.
Yeah.
What is it about the prep school route that works for people?
If you ever go down to any of these campuses,
they're beautiful.
$30 million art centers, $20 million athletic centers. It's, 1-to-6 ratio in class. It's the cream of the crop. 1% of the United States population gets to go to prep school, or a boarding school, as some of them call it. So, our kids are very lucky. They're good with giving financial aid to the Canadians. These schools cost up to $50,000. You have to do a lot of work. It's not as easy as getting drafted and saying, hey, come to my team. I'll give you this, this, and that. It's you have to go to them. You have to, we'll travel to, more than 12 prep schools this year, meeting coaches and letting them
see.
So
are these
kids.
All different prep schools? Do you go to the same showcase? Like, I know every second week your juvenile team, which is a great hockey team, travels on a bus and you guys go to the Boston area. Are you always going to the same area?
No, we go all over New England.
Okay.
We're going October 5th. We're going to the Mass area, Massachusetts. We'll visit four schools there.
Okay.
Then 2 weeks from that, we'll go more to the Connecticut, New York area. We'll visit, more than...
Now, you're visiting the
states.
Schools. You're checking out the schools.
Yeah.
Are you playing at the schools? Or
yeah.
Are you playing against the schools?
Yeah.
Or are these schools visiting you while you're playing in a tournament?
Both. Okay. You know, we'll email all the coaches saying, hey, we're playing at so-and-so school. Come watch us if you're available. A lot of these schools are very close to each other. So, you know, a typical day is we play in the morning. We have lunch at the school with other students. We get toured by the school so that our kids are, you know, familiar with the process, and it opens their eyes. And it's not like, oh, I want to go to prep school. It's like, well, you really know what you're getting yourself into, and the parents know as well.
Do all the kids at Cooper, are they able to go to every trip, or that doesn't happen?
Yeah, I mean, the kids on our hockey team don't play any other team, so their devotion is to Cooper. We play up to 40 games a year.
And that includes the tours?
That includes the tours, yep.
And that's one of the aspects when you're trying to lure someone to play at Cooper, saying, you know, our regular season may be 20 games or however long it is, but you're going to get 20 extra games of showcasing down south for a potential scholarship at a prep school.
What we try and do is, you know, we preach going to prep school, and we do a lot of the work for the parents because, you know, the parents have been in the, you know, they've been playing Ad and then Pee Wee, then Bantam. It's the same. And now you have the option to go four or five different ways, and the parents just have no idea. They're like, well, where do I go? What do I do? Do I stay in Quebec?
The parents are busy already. I mean, if they're not working, getting the kids ready to go to school and all that other stuff. A lot of parents haven't got time to travel to all these places.
Yeah.
And John does a great guidance job.
Yeah, that's we try and do most of the work for the parents. So it's a demanding process, but you know, it's a lot of fun. We love it.
Now, okay. I want to get to one of the showcase games before I think I know where you're going to go.
Okay.
But when I played in Bantam, we took a team and did a showcase.
We're reminiscing now.
Yeah. No, but we weren't double A's. We're kind of double B's, double C's.
Double
we did a showcase.
C's. And I understand
what you're, but I understand what you're saying with the showcase and what that does. When the kids are there, how wide-eyed are they if they've never been there before?
It's a demanding process because you might only get, you know, 20 minutes. This coach might see you for only 20 minutes. Mm-hmm. So it's a tough one. You know, we play every game like it's our last. They have to, the kids. They know that it's do or die. You know, these coaches are not going to come to Montreal that much. They may come a bit, but, you know, you got to build a relationship with them. If they like you on the ice, then you can build a relationship off the ice, which is, you know, the more important thing.
Have you ever seen some of the kids, crack under pressure or not being able to perform because they have too much pressure on them where they go, I've only got 20 minutes to impress this guy? And,
you know, that's where we've built a relationship. We have over 90 kids in prep schools in the last 4 years in all sports at Cooper. So that's when, you know, we say, hey, look, this kid, you know, he had a bad game, but he'll perform for you. And it happened last year, and the coach, he got references from other people, but, you know, we said he'll perform for you, and, you know, we hope he does well this year.
But I don't think John's saying, but I've heard from George Martin, the athletic director at Cooper. John Silver's got quite the reputation with the prep schools, and whatever John says, these guys listen because they know. They've, like, just in the past 2 years, 22 hockey players.
Yeah, on our team, yeah, 22.
22 players in the last 2 years have gone to prep schools. They know John. They believe in John. If John says this, they'll agree with him. Now, academics, we didn't touch on the academic part, and I'm all about academics. You got to bring that to the table, too.
Right? Yeah, that's the biggest part. I mean, our kids, you know, they can't leave school and practice with us if they don't have, you know, over a certain average. And they know we do a lot of tutoring.
Does that happen often?
We've had Jake at the house a couple times.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Jake's a good friend. He helps all our kids with the tutoring. And, you know, it's a big component is the SSATs. That's, you know, a way to, you know, compare the Canadians with the Americans and so forth. So it does happen. You know, as a coach,
are you disappointed, or you just take it in stride and you go, this is an opportunity for another kid? Like, your top line guy, he didn't make the grade this week, he can't play this week, so you're like, are you upset at him, or you're like, he's going to be better for him in the long run because he's going to learn, or are you like, this is a great opportunity for
at the end of the day, these kids are old enough now that I could talk to them, you know, as a friend on a friendly basis that says, hey, listen, if you can't do it here when your parents are here and you're getting all this help, how are you going to do it when you're 5 hours away in a prep school with no one watching you? You know, they'll watch you at prep school, but it's, you know, they gotta be mature enough that they can do it on their own. And we tell them once, and usually it works out. If we have to tell them again, it's...
Now Cooper is a great school, and my wife wanted me to reinforce that this morning, not only saying great teachers, great program, great sports program.
Does your kid go there?
Yeah, he does. does.
Okay.
Best thing that happened. I mean, it's a par five from my house,
right.
and it's a great school. But no, we got to understand also is that the prep schools, it's a great way to get an academic route, go the academic route, because it's such a regiment. It's like the military. How can they do bad? After practice, yeah. You've got X amount of hours, or you have to go to study hall.
Right.
At home, they're going to the Xbox 360 room, right?
Exactly.
So
yeah.
I think if kids might be a little weak in the academics, I think it's a great potential opportunity, I should say, at the prep school level to improve also. So yeah. If you're going in there with an 80, you probably walk out of there with a 90 because yeah. It's got such a great structure, small classrooms, a study hall, etc.
Yeah.
Played Again radio show, Sean Campbell, Keith Pogue, Gerard Gantz with you. Our guest is John Silver from Cooper and Athletic Republic. And just tying it all in with the prep schools and how you are linked with them with Cooper, you're actually having a showcase coming up at Athletic Republic for prep school coaches that are coming into town?
Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be November 19th at Pierre Fonkat Glass. We have about 25 coaches coming in to watch some of the best players in the region, outside the region as well. We'll have about 140 kids playing. And
how do you determine which kids are part of the showcase?
We've been very selective in that. Really kids that are enthusiastic about prep school and that they want to, get to that next level. We've had certain organizations, the Lions, we've had all our Cooper kids, the Tigers have helped us out a lot, and then other kids within, Bantam AA area. So it's been great. We're excited. The coaches are all excited, and should be a lot of fun. So if you're around Monday, November 19th, come by.
All right, we'll check it out.
Glass beer phone, right?
Yeah, we'll take one quick break. I want to come back. I want to know where these prep school kids end up. We touched on Europe a little earlier, and I know that you say you have connections in Europe. I know that that's a link to what's happening with the NHL now with the lockout. Everybody wants to go to Europe, and maybe they'll just stay there forever. We'll find out a little bit more on the Play It Again radio show on TSN 690.